I'd like to welcome Meenakshi ma'am. She is principal at Sri Chaitanya Techno Schools, JP Nagar. She conducts regular teacher training and parenting workshops and has volunteered with reputed NGOs for child welfare and UNICEF. She is a proud recipient of awards like Best Principals for Euro Kids in 2010-11, Best Principal of the Year, ECDF Pinnacle Education Awards 2020. It is a pleasure to have you with us, ma'am.
It's a pleasure to have you too. And thank you for inviting me with such, you know, renowned principals. It's a pleasure to be a part of, you know, a discussion where two renowned principals are there. It's a learning, especially, and sharing experience from different part of the world that you have collected principals and educationists. It's seriously a good moment for me to be in the team and, you know, to hear what we all are facing in this pandemic. I mean, seriously, the different part of India has different experience. So like all Gitanjali ma'am and Monika ma'am has told, it's same what we are experiencing here in South India. But yes, we all are in the same boat. We all are experiencing the same thing, but handling and their own experience differ. But yes, thank you for making me a part of this discussion. Thank you very much.
What methods are schools using to implement experiential learning during online classes?
We are modifying. The teachers are getting, you know, taking different methods to modify their curriculum, what we had earlier, to come, you know, come with to e-curriculum. Then the, you know, the teaching, the techniques which we used to in classroom was different to the online education. So the one-on-one ratio has been changed to a group of sessions, and, you know, the activities are different. Yes, we are focusing on, you know, the child-driven, that is based on the intellectual part and skills. More than that, the teachers are seriously learning from the students. Even we are learning from the students, like how to come up with the new projects, how to do the projects, and the analyzation of the students are basically on the skill development. And learning is on daily process. It's not one day learning. It's we are learning, we are modifying, we are again, you know, rectifying our mistakes, and again we are going back to what more we can put into the projects. Yes, it's an advantage in e-learning that we can, you know, bring up more things, more you know, examples through virtual learning. More you know, the V projects can be shown more. Yes, the disadvantage is there, that one-on-one, what I personally feel, that the ratio of the students wherein the questions were there arose by the students are little lacked, because it's an online class. The teacher cannot focus to so many students. It's a batch of 30 students or 20 students per 40 minutes. So that is a little bit of lack that we what we faced. But yes, we are learning through our mistakes. We are modifying again. And the projects are like, we do, you know, focus on the knowledge and experience things to the teachers. You know, the enhancement, the modification, how to teach them, how to make them techno-savvy, then how to analyze a child, basics on the skills, rather than how much marks is he getting.
What role has technology played in advancement of experiential learning?
It's a major part that has been played, I can say. This has played, it's the major backbone, I can say, for this experiential learning, for this online education, because of that only we are running everything online. Yeah, there are, the major part is for the technology, is like what I'll agree to Mr. Ashutosh and sir also. And Gita ma'am, for Gitanjali ma'am also, that it was there from last so long. It's not that we have been implemented just now. No. We were doing it from so long. As ma'am said, we were doing so many things. We were, you know, learning, and we were just going to the exams. Even I stand in the same situation, yes, I did, I learned. But yes, what new? So this technology has brought something new to where we can explore more. Like how Mr. Ashutosh said, like Google Earth and navigation. these all are new points where we can, you know, that brings life, new concepts for the students, that we can, you know, bring excitement to the class. So where, and we can learn from the students, and sometimes it happens that we don't know and the solution comes from the students, like how to go. It happened in my class, in one of the class, where the teacher was stuck with some project and the students shared the screen, like, ma'am, you wait, I'll share the screen, I'll teach you how to, you know, go with different students and how to bring up the projects and how to, you know, modify from one class to another. This was a learning for the teacher. So it's not that the teachers are not learning, we are also learning. We don't know how to, even till date, I was not aware how to, you know, change the screens and go. Even I learned from my students. So when we learn to go to the class, something new, every day, it's a new chapter. It happens in our own life also. We learn every day. Every day is a new learning from some or the other places, which we just, you know, let go, or we just overlook things. We don't, you know, bother about it. But being coming to this education, when it is online, we focus on more like how to bring creativity. What are the new concepts? Let us bring this also. Let us put, you know, some, you know, new projects or something online. Live streaming can be done, which was in the regular classes was not there, which brings, literally I feel like that brings more excitement and more happening to the class, where the students are more attracted, like what is going to happen next, what's next. So even the teacher is excited, I'm going to do this to the class today. Today I'm going to teach this with live streaming, I'm going to go there and it's a live stream. So that brings excitement to the class. So it's a, you know, being a dull class, it's a more happening class. So the outcome is more, the learning is more, the experience is more, the questioning is more, the reasoning is more, the thinking skills is definitely more. So it's more of the technology, yes. In today's world, acceptance to the mistake is really hard. But with this technology, seriously, the kids accept what they did wrong, and they know what went wrong in their project. You can say any project, you can say any classwork, and pertaining to anything, they accept and they come back with a positive note. Yes, I went wrong here. Yesterday I did this wrong, so I have, you know, modified this. So it's a problem solving technique, what we can say, which is a positive thing. Like they have come up with a solution by their own, and the major thing is accepting in a positive manner. It's not like I'm humiliated in front of so many people, I did wrong. No, it's like I have done wrong, let me learn something new. What have I earned from this? This was my mistake, okay, let me rectify this and come up with a solution. So it's on a very positive note. Yes, they are coming with the solutions, they are coming with their own problem solving techniques, and you know, the experience that which they are gaining by themselves, it's seriously huge with this technology. Thank you.